become artist. Like, subscribe, and ring that bell. In my descriptions below, there will be a link for the picture of the bird, a value study, and a sketch so you can paint right along with me. Copyright comes from, and I really can't say his name, Devdutta Banji? Oh, if I killed your name, I am so sorry. It's right there. I'm gonna put it up top so you can see it. But anyway, he is an amazing artist, and he allowed people who on free references for artists on Facebook, and he puts his stuff out there and allows you to paint, which is so totally cool. I looked up his Facebook page. Oh my God, he's got amazing birds. This little guy is called an Indian roller. It is so cute and had such pretty colors. I just had to paint it. When we talk about colors, I used many more colors than I normally do, but birds have different colors, so I really had to work on it. So I'm gonna put a list of the colors that I'm using so you can see it. I will be talking over the video because I lost all my sound. Never a good thing, but you know, I'm learning. This whole editing thing, it's quite an experience, let me tell you. So anyway, I'll be talking over it. I'll be telling you what I'm doing. So let's go paint a bird. So I'm looking at my brushes. I have a Princeton Velvet Touch 8 and a 12 round. And I also have a flat that I use to pull up information. Now I am using Aussie Gold and a little bit of Vermilion just to kind of get things started. I'm wanting to run a simple wash using the lighter colors first. And so I'm going to do a quick wash. See where I am holding the brush farther in the barrel, and this helps me to be more loose and trying to get a quick dry brush stroke. I'm actually throwing some paint into the background. Thank you.
So I am trying to grab Dawn Andrews turquoise so I can get that beautiful crest of the bird. And phthalo blue for the darker parts of the crest. Using trying to make sure that I get a actual dry brush strokes. The purple area, there's also some small parts of Aussie that makes it kind of fun. I am mixing a dark for the beak. I'm looking for a very beautiful blue violet in this area. I'm looking for a dark in order for the feet. So I'm using some of the Aussie to try to do some dry brush for a branch. I'm now taking some of the branch color into the background. I'm using red oxide and vermilion, trying to get a warm brown. I'm using a little of the purple into darken the to a darker brown. I'm now softening areas. I see that things are some hard edges, and so I'm just softening with water. I'm adding red oxide to what's a little darker. I am using dark for the eye and some dark around the beak. I have switched over to a 8 round. Now I'm using a flat brush so I could pull out information. I added the darks and now I'm pulling out lights so that it would be that interesting combo of lights and darks underneath his breast and his neck. So I'm making darks so that I can go around and every place that is supposed to be dark is dark. Thank you. Ready now to get that fun background done now. I'm over there and I have all these little dots and stuff, but I don't have it on the other side, so I better do it on the other side too. Whoops, I thought it was a little more drier than that. Obviously not. So I'm looking at this whole thing wondering, whoa, look at that. And as this part of the branch, it was totally draining out. And I did to go back through and try to fix it. I just had a little issues. Should have dropped the brush at this point. As I'm looking at myself, it kept moving around. I was trying, and it's quite thick. I'm pulling out thick paint, but it's actually, it just drifts off, and I can't seem to get it to stop. What I should have done is stop, but I kept working on it. Oops. Thank you.
You know, this new brush, I used my new brush, the Princeton Velvet Touch 12. Great tip. Man, I was able to get an amazing tip, but it didn't hold as much water as I'm used to, so I kept doing brush stroking, and it's okay, because it actually kind of worked really well with a bird, and it looks good with animals, period. But, you know, it's still a process, and I'm learning. So I'll let you know, continue to monitor how I'm doing the brush and see if this is the one or if I have to look some more. Birds are so fun. I've only done a couple of birds, but that came out so fun. I'm gonna do a few more. So watch my videos. There'll be some that are coming out with birds just because they're fun. Go down to my description and you will have the picture, the value study, and the sketch. And paint on with me. Make sure if you paint, put it on my Facebook, drop that brush. When you don't know what you're doing and you're just playing with the brush, and the more I figure I'll just keep putting paint on it and it'll get better, it doesn't. Drop that brush. You have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next week.